Hello, everybody. My name is Ron Gonen. I'm the co-founder and CEO of RecycleBank. Before I get started with the presentation, I have a question for everyone in the audience. Does anybody know what this map represents? Anybody? Show of hands. Anybody want to take a guess? Close. Go a little bit further with that. You're on the right path. Great, thank you. So this is a map that I saw in 2002. And without knowing much about the waste business, the recycling industry, logistics, I knew something wasn't good here. There was a massive inefficiency. And when you see massive inefficiencies, there's a business opportunity. Do I have anybody here from Michigan? Anybody here from the state of Michigan? All right, back there. So in the state of Michigan, you accept garbage from the city of Toronto, one of the largest cities in the world, trucks its garbage to the state of Michigan and dumps in the state of Michigan. We have anybody here from Pennsylvania? Pennsylvania? Anybody? All right, back there. Okay. Pennsylvania is the largest importer of garbage in America. So, So Pennsylvania takes in more garbage from out of state than any other state in America. So there's a lot of real estate and really beautiful land in the state of Pennsylvania that's used for storing other people's garbage. Anybody here from New Jersey? All right. So New Jersey. There's something very special about New Jersey. There's many things that are very special about New Jersey, but in this case, there's one very special thing. New Jersey, contrary to popular belief, does not import garbage. They passed a law a few years ago where they will not accept garbage from outside of the state. That was in order to save its own landfill space, and there just was a feeling that they didn't want to import other folks' garbage. Why is that important to New Jersey? Because the states around New Jersey, like Pennsylvania, do accept everyone else's garbage, and so if you're on the turnpike very late at night or very early on in the morning and you're wondering what all those massive trucks are, a lot of them aren't actually delivering goods and foods and services to different people. They're actually trucking garbage from New York or Connecticut to Pennsylvania. So I saw this map and I started looking into it and I realized there's a massive inefficiency here. We are delivering garbage that's recyclable all over the country to landfills that are charging a lot of money. And I looked for a solution. So just to walk you through what this all looks like before I get to what the solution is, these are products that we buy every day. These are great brands. These are great products. For the most part in America, instead of being recycled, they're actually thrown in the garbage, put in a truck, and driven all over the country looking for landfill space. That's basically what a landfill looks like. They've gotten more modern, and some of them are more developed. But at the end of the day, you're taking material that could be recycled, put back in the manufacturing stream, and instead it's just left in a hole. And then we end up going and cutting down more trees or pulling more oil out of the ground or more ore out of the ground to create more products. Extremely inefficient. And so I look for a solution. How could we get all of these products recycled? Well, I realize that there's got to be some money there someplace. If cities are paying all of this money to truck their garbage someplace and then having to spend to stick this garbage in a landfill, and companies are scouring the world trying to find material so that they can manufacture out of recycled product instead of virgin petroleum or cut down trees, there's got to be some value there. But that value is not going to be created unless you pass the value back to the entity that's ensuring that all the stuff is getting recycled, namely the household. So once I realized that, I had to think of a way to reward households for recycling, okay? And most of us do what we do, whether it be show up at work on time and work hard or decide to take out a mortgage because we can write the interest off of our taxes. Most of us do what we do because somebody is motivating us to do it. They have aligned incentives for us to do it. And so we looked for a way to reward households for the amount that they recycle. So how do we do that? We sign contracts with cities. They're 5, 10, 20-year contracts. We provide our RecycleBank recycling containers. There's a chip embedded in your RecycleBank recycling container. We retrofit the city's trucks or the hauler's trucks. We don't own any trucks. So we retrofit the city's trucks with a mechanical arm that picks up your container, reads the chip, identifies that your home recycled and how much your home recycled. That information is then wired to our servers. We run an algorithm, and we post credit to your account for the amount that you've recycled. You can earn about $400 a year via recycling. So, go back here for a second. This is our homepage. You can come and put in your email address and password. You get to your account page. You can see that you can put your picture in there. You can create your own profile. That's what you're seeing over there on the right-hand side. We can show you each week you've recycled, how much you recycled, how many RecycleBank points you earned. You can see up there on the upper right-hand side, we show you your environmental footprint. You can see how many trees your home has saved by recycling, how much oil your home has saved by recycling. This is about you and what you are doing. Over on the bottom left-hand side, that's your inbox. We can send you different messages from your city, whether or not the truck is broken down, you've been given a different route, there's an e-waste collection coming up, there's a green festival. We can message you in your inbox. But at the bottom line, you're here because you've recycled and you want to use your points to shop. Our focus is not necessarily the people who are really green or have been environmentalists for a long time. We appreciate those folks. They're wonderful. They've gotten us to this point, and they're going to continue to be leaders. Our focus was, how do I take somebody earning $35,000 a year living in Hartford, Connecticut, who just can't worry about this environmental stuff right now, and get them to recycle? Or how do I take someone in Lower Gwynedd, Pennsylvania, which is one of the highest earning communities in the country, and the person says, look, I just want to drive my SUV. I don't want people to bother me with my screen stuff. How can I motivate them to recycle? And we found that by creating a robust rewards program, you can motivate people to do the right thing. So you can go right from your account page to the category section. We are today the world's largest rewards program by partners. We have over 1,700 different reward partners, from local businesses to regional businesses to national businesses to global businesses. So if you're in our rewards program, if you want to use your points at the local hardware store, the local pizza shop, the local beauty parlor, or you want to use your points at the grocery store, you want to use your points for an online purchase, you can do that. Our focus has been, how do we make sure that every single person in every community that we service finds motivation from our rewards program? We have another option, which is you can donate your RecycleBank points to local schools, so local schools can come online in the communities that we service and apply for grants, whether it be a composting project or a solar project, and households can donate their points to those schools. And we have a partnership via the Coca-Cola Company where they will match the donated points with a real dollar contribution. The way you get your rewards is in two ways. If you want to shop locally, you get a reward mailer in the mail. So you see this person is going to Shaw's supermarket, and they're going to be buying Kraft product. If you want to shop online, we will email you a promo code, and you can shop online. It's your choice where you want to use your reward points. This just gives you a sample of who our different reward partners are. So hopefully you can see something in here that attracts you and would motivate you to recycle. So the question is, does it work, right? Great idea. I used to tell people about my idea, and they'd say, oh, that's awesome if you can actually pay people for recycling. But at the end of the day, does it work, right? And so this gives you some statistical evidence of what our service is doing today. We're providing service in over 20 states. We launched service in the UK on Monday. We're servicing over 1 million people today. We have some of the largest cities in America that have signed contracts with us. We have some of the smallest towns that have signed contracts with us, but you can see the impact that we're having in the different communities that we're servicing. The reason I chose this slide is you have Wilmington, Delaware, your typical mid-sized city in America. You have Everett, Massachusetts. It borders the city of Boston. You have Clayton, New Jersey, which is sort of a rural suburb. You have Cherry Hill, New Jersey, which is an affluent suburb. So you can see that the program works in all different types of communities. We provide another service, which is we help municipalities and haulers become more efficient. Those trucks that are driving around picking up recycling as well as garbage and anything else, they're very expensive trucks with very expensive labor with even more expensive fuel. And we have a technology now that tracks where's the truck, who's it picking up from, how much is it picking up, so on and so forth. So we can help haulers and cities increase their routing efficiency. Gives you an idea of what some different mayors are saying about us. You can see over there in North Miami, we launched in North Miami about 6 months ago. That's Cherry Hill, New Jersey, and then Clayton, New Jersey. Distinctly different communities, but the same impact. And this gives you an idea of some of the recognition and awards that we've been fortunate enough to be recognized with. And I think a lot of that is coming from if you think about a lot of the discussions in the green space, it's been around solar, it's been around wind, it's been around the electric car, and all of those are very, very important. And I think over the next 10 or 20 years, you're going to see them have a major impact. Some of the other discussions that go on are on climate change or global warming. But I can tell you from visiting all of these different communities, when you go up to the average American and you say climate change, you say global warming, you say the electric car, you say solar, they say, yeah, that's important, and we know it needs to be done, but either I don't know how to do it, I can't afford to do it, I don't have time to do it. And I think we've started getting a significant amount of press and recognition because this is something that somebody can do today and actually have a massive impact on their community, both from a financial perspective as well as an environmental perspective. And they can also have an impact on their household from a financial perspective and an environmental perspective. And so we feel fortunate to get this type of recognition. And that is my overview of RecycleBank.